Here we go.
Follow us on Instagram at Karen Carson in the Morning and text us anytime at 1-800-949-1027.
Message and data rates apply.
Hi, NEW102.7. Who's this?
Hi, this is Jamie.
Jamie, tell us your favorite healthy item on your grocery list to feed your moment.
Lately, mushrooms are my favorite.
Oh my gosh, I just bought portobellos. What kind do you get?
I like all. I like portobellos too, but Stop and Shop has the best produce, best mushrooms, and that's where I get mine.
I love it. Well, congrats. You just won a $100 gift card from Stop and Shop.
Fantastic. Thank you.
Discover your mushrooms and all your fresh variety you need to follow your healthy at Stop and Shop. For every list, for every healthy, for every moment, Stop and Shop, feed the moment.
Didn't Super Mario like mushrooms too?
Only you would say that, John.
New 102.7 WNEW FM WNEW HD1 New York. Commercial free at 9, noon, 2, and 3.
An Odyssey station.
This song went viral, and she is putting out an EP this summer. Her name is M. Byhold, Numb Little Bug on New 102.7. I love her. That is M. Byhold and Numb Little Bug. On New 102.7, happy Wednesday, halfway to the weekend. And everybody is making memes about Amber Heard again. Kind of because she went on the Today Show to speak with Savannah Guthrie. And I don't want to pick on her. I mean, I think they both were abusive in this relationship. Yeah. You know what I mean? But every time she goes on TV, she makes herself look worse. I'm just going to say it.
It's true.
And of course, you want to believe a victim, but she just making herself. She's not having a really good argument here.
She's not. And she told Savannah that she was abused, which she just got sued for. And if that's the case, don't go on TV. Go back to your lawyer. Uh-huh. Get a case together and fix it. But she did. And she sat down and, you know, Savannah had some tough questions for her. Her answer... Well, hear for yourself.
In the closing arguments, the Depp lawyers called your testimony the performance of a lifetime and said you were acting. What do you say to that?
Says the lawyer for the man who convinced the world he had scissors for fingers. I'm the performer.
Yes, he did convince the world he had scissors for fingers because he was in a movie that had, you know, scissors on your hand.
Right, in a movie.
Wait a second, hang on.
In a movie.
You're telling me Johnny Depp doesn't actually have scissors for fingers? Wait, is that
Johnny,
true?
Johnny, I'm sorry to break it to you.
I mean, is Willem Dafoe going to be, you know, arrested for trying to kill Spider-Man? Did Jim Carrey really try to steal Christmas?
She's missing the point.
Oh, Amber.
Yeah, so that happened. There are just memes everywhere. And, you know, now they're saying that she got cut from Aquaman 2.
Is that true?
I saw it all over the news yesterday. And then she put that to rest saying that's, you know, ridiculous.
Wait, and Aquaman's not real either?
Oh, no.
Right.
I feel bad almost making fun of her, but...
I know.
She's doing this to herself.
It's so uncomfortable.
She's digging the hole.
Right. Just stop. Yes, you're both actors.
It's almost
you
wrong
performed
to make fun.
And so did he.
It's like making fun of someone who may have a mental condition.
That's what I'm
saying.
Because
there's something wrong here.
Yeah, yeah. So that happened.
Wait, Johnny Depp isn't Captain Jack Sparrow? You best start believing in ghost stories, Miss Turner.
Yes, he did make the world believe he was Edward Scissorhands, because that's what he does for a living.
It's a movie.
Oh, I'm sorry to break that to you, Johnny. Be okay with it. So you showed me a video this morning when I walked in.
So
that's
great.
Pretty amazing, and I love this story.
Well, if you're keeping up with the NBA Finals, so this YouTuber pulled off the sickest prank I've ever seen, Kar, at the NBA Finals. So Game 5 was Monday. Now, let me quiz intern Anthony. Who is in the NBA Finals right now?
Michael Jackson.
I know it's the Warriors.
Versus the
Michael
Celtics.
Michael Jackson. Jeez.
Very good, Kara. The Warriors versus the Celtics, and the Warriors are up right now. So Klay Thompson is one of the best players on the court. He plays for the Warriors.
Okay.
And this YouTuber, his name is Big Dawes TV. He looks just like Klay Thompson.
Really? Tall and everything?
He's tall.
Wow.
He's good at basketball. So he got his hair cut to look exactly like Klay Thompson.
Oh, no.
And he snuck onto the Warriors court during warm-ups and started taking shots. He got about 25 shots off.
First of all, I watched him do this. He's really good.
He's hitting threes.
So he fooled everybody in the arena that was getting ready for the game, like the security and the workers.
Fired about 20 shots off until security finally realized, and then they kicked him out and they banned him for life from the stadium.
So how did he get caught?
So, well, I guess one of the security guards.
Wait, I just left you in the locker room. Yeah, what are you doing here?
I realized, wait, you're not Clay. Because we're going to post a video. Karen Carson in the morning. He looks a little off. He doesn't look exactly like Clay. But, like, he's walking through the locker room.
He literally walked in.
Fans are taking pictures with him. The staff is like, yo, Clay, let's get a W tonight.
Yeah, it's amazing.
It's absolutely wild. And also, he got in by just simply walking up to the doors.
I know.
Like, and knocking, like, that's on the knock, knock, knock. And security literally let him in.
That's
just
insane.
Let him right in.
I just want to warm up a little bit.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, do you mind? Oh, my gosh.
But banned for life. Come on. It's not his fault. They let him in.
They did. Well, security, you know, when he was putting his stuff through the conveyor belt, people were like, yo, man, what's up? Like, he literally just walked onto the court. Can we put that video up?
We're going to put it up. Karen Carson in the morning. He also did this a few years ago. This is the second time he's done this.
Well, now they know. Yeah, so that's why he's banned for life. Man.
Let's go Warriors.
Unreal. All right. It's time to play Can't Be Karen. Do you want to play 5 pop culture trivia questions with me? Your prize. And we've been drooling over this all morning. Edible arrangements for Father's Day. We're talking fruit. Chocolate-covered fruit, cookie, it's amazing.
It's awesome.
Visit your local edible arrangement store today, okay? So, yeah, we'll go against each other. 5 pop culture trivia questions. You'll get that, no matter the score, and it can't be Karen mug. And there's money when you beat me, $102, and the winning mug.
Edible arrangements. What's that song you guys always sing from the Wiggles?
Oh, fruit salad. Yummy.
Thank you. All right, so that's your prize. Call now, 800-949-1027. Odyssey Lottery Recap is presented by Jackpocket. Powerball is now $258 million. Mega Millions is $273 million. Play Powerball and Mega Millions on your phone using the Jackpocket app. You must be 18 or older to play. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-877-8-HOPE-NY.
Get more out of your day, New York, with Duncan.
Heard the latest.
Here we go.
Follow us on Instagram at Karen Carson in the morning and text us anytime at 1-800-949-1027.
Message and data rates apply. The most music for your workday.
New 102.7.
New 102.7. If you've seen the scene in Stranger Things with this song, you know what I'm talking about. Intern Anthony gets chills every time.
Yes!
It's Kate Bush running up that hill. Netflix made it popular. It's back from 1985 on New 102.7. Hey, New 102.7, who's this?
Oh, this is Karen.
Karen? I'm Karen.
Oh my God!
Yes!
Oh my gosh, you know, the title of this show, the title of this game can be reversed. You can't be Karen, right? I could actually be afraid of her now.
Huh? It's the Battle of the Karens on New 102.7.
You want to play, Karen?
Yes, I do, and I have my 2 daughters here.
Awesome!
All right, Karen, kick other Karen out of the room. Too many Karens to keep up with Anthony.
Way too many, yeah.
Don't hide your managers. I'm just saying.
Okay, Karen, please exit the building.
The building?
Well, I might not come back for a while if I do that, so I'll just step outside the room. Is that good?
That's perfect.
All right. She's leaving. There's the door. You got to get more points than Karen, our Karen, to win this game. And it's time to play. Johnny, by the way, one way or another, Karen is going to win. Can't be Karen.
Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Again, can you be Karen? Yeah. Okay, then.
Number one, Karen, Blinding Lights and Take My Breath are songs from what artist?
The Weeknd.
Which of the two have played the villain, the Joker? Joaquin Phoenix or Leonardo DiCaprio?
Joaquin Phoenix.
Slim Shady is the nickname of what rapper?
Oh, Eminem.
Who is the main star of the UK version of The Office?
Oh.
Come on, Karen.
Oh. God, no
seconds.
Idea.
Oh,
time I'm born there, but that's about it.
Is up. All right, we'll move on to the final question. True or false, Post Malone was raised in Staten Island?
True.
Okay.
Karen. No,
this ain't
false.
Oh, come on. Let her change her answer. She was in the 3 seconds.
What's your answer?
Final answer is false.
Okay. You got a point for that one. Okay. You got 4 out of 5 correct. I'm in a good mood today. It's nice out.
They won't talk.
Yeah. All right. We're going to get Karen, our Karen, back in the room and see how she does on Can't Beat Karen versus Karen. Okay?
Okay. Perfect.
The people have spoken. They like when our new intern, Janet Planet, gets Karen back. She's very violent. Go get Karen in here.
Karen, it's time!
Oh, my God! Kids today.
Oh, my God. I'm afraid of Janet Planet the intern. Yeah. Did you hear that?
The molding's cracking on the ceiling
she
from that.
She is sassy. Okay, I'm ready to take on Karen.
Number one, Karen, Blinding Lights and Take My Breath are songs from what artist?
The Weeknd.
That's the correct answer. Karen and Karen get a point.
Oh, God.
Which of the two have played the villain, the Joker? Joaquin Phoenix or Leonardo DiCaprio?
Oh, it's definitely Joaquin Phoenix.
Yes, it is. Another point for everyone.
Although, Leo would be an interesting Joker.
I don't see him.
I don't see it. I see
no
it.
No way. He doesn't belong there.
Number three, Slim Shady is the nickname of what rapper?
Eminem.
Yes, it is. Another point for everyone. Who is the main star of the UK version of The Office? We have Steve Carell.
Ricky Gervais.
That's the correct answer.
He developed it, I think. He wrote it.
He did. He wrote it and started.
Yeah.
You got a point for that one. Karen did not.
I feel so smart. Oh, sorry, Karen. I didn't mean to. No, that sounded bad.
Yeah, it did. It really did. Sorry, other Karen.
I was just proud of myself for a minute.
Final question. True or false, Post Malone was raised in Staten Island?
I'm going to say false because you didn't claim him and you claim everybody from New York.
It
so
is true.
I want to say the Midwest or something.
He was raised in New York, but guess what? He was not from Staten Island. You got a point for that one. So did other Karen.
Whoa, wait.
Other Karen got 4 out of 5 correct. Uh-oh. You sneak by with 1 extra point.
Oh,
5 out of 5.
Karen, you're good.
No, my girls are good.
We do have to boo our Karen, though.
Boo
our Karen.
Boo.
All right, guys. It was,
The kids.
I love just being booed by the tri-state.
By the whole family.
Well, congratulations, Karen. You got an Edible Arrangements for Father's Day. Visit Edible Arrangements store today. And also, you got a Can't Be Karen mug. And your whole team did really, really well on Can't Be Karen.
Thank you. And I know what I have to say. We tried, but guess what? We're both called Karen, so... In a way, I can beat Karen, but I can't beat Karen.
And you know what, Karen? I could say the same thing. In a way, I can't beat Karen, but I can beat Karen.
That didn't make any sense.
I'm so lost right now.
Can you be Karen? No. Next time, then.
Here's my brother, Stu.
Oh. Studio.
Help care that cares.
Turn it up.
New 102.7.
I miss you more than.
New 102.7, we're going to try to make love happen again with our brand new Blown Off. That's next.
To the left.
So on Blown Off today, we have Harold with us. Hi, Harold.
Hello, good morning.
What's up?
So we read that your girlfriend, Tara, who you've been with for almost 9 years, has started to back away.
She just started ghosting me, you know? She was practically like my wife, and, you know, we've been together for so long. I don't understand how she could just pack up and leave.
Well,
you know?
I mean, 9 years. Is there a reason that you haven't maybe taken a leap, to put it nicely?
I mean, is it necessary? I mean, we've been together for 9 years. You know, I don't think it's...
Right.
I don't think at that point, I don't think it's really all that important. I don't want to get any of my friends and family involved. I don't want to, you know, bother them. So I called you guys. Hopefully they won't recognize our voices on the radio. You know, well, I mean, like, it's a little early. Family hasn't gotten up yet.
That's true.
So I think... I feel like you guys can help me out here. I did notice she kind of dragged herself around the apartment in a bad mood last week. But then, like, she just blew me away and said she was leaving, you know?
Oh.
And like, she just packed up and left.
There it is, Harold. I didn't know that she left. I thought she was kind of backing away here. Okay, that's pretty serious. Okay, we're going to make a phone call for you and call
Tara.
Okay,
thanks.
All right?
Yeah, thanks.
That phone call comes next on Blown Off on New 102.7.
If you any moment it's your dog, you can look at lost.
We have a very upset Harold on the phone. So Harold, she packed up and left. Her name is Tara. You guys have been together for 9 years.
Oh.
Let's do this, okay? Harold, you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Here we go. We're going to call Tara and hopefully get her on the phone and get an answer for you. She usually around this early?
Hello?
Oh, hi. Is this Tara?
Yes,
hi.
Tara.
Hi, Tara. This is Karen and Johnny from New 102.7 Radio.
Oh, okay.
Tara, we are sending you on a VIP exclusive date with your boyfriend of 9 years, Harold.
What do you think?
Oh, no.
Tara, we're going to pay for the whole thing. Harold reached out to us. He is so very upset. I mean, like actually crying.
No, I am not interested in this. It's just time for me to move on. I'm sorry.
What happened? Like 9 years, that you're going to throw 9 years out the window?
Oh, my God. Well, you know what? No. We've been together for 9 years, and not once, not even one time have we had a discussion about getting married, and he clearly doesn't even want to. You know what I mean? Like, just call him back. I don't want you to tell him to find a new woman to use for 9 years. I'm sorry.
Had the conversation with him?
No. What?
Tara.
No. Huh?
Tara, I'm right here.
You can talk to him, Tara. I know it's shocking. Sorry.
Tara.
Did we lose Tara?
Tara, I'm sorry. I'm done with you. I'm just, you know, all my friends are married, and, you know, they're even on their second child, and I'm just, like, we barely even live together, and all I've wanted is a commitment, and I never wanted to force you into it, so, like, I just never brought it up, and I just, you know, I realized it's time to move on, so...
But look, Tara, you're like my wife already.
No. I was like your wife, you know what I mean? I was like your wife. Now, you know what I am? Is your ex-girlfriend.
Okay. Harold, are you hearing her?
Hey, can you guys just hang up and I'll go try to find her.
Harold, you you called us.
No, you know what? Let the whole f***ing dating world know that you, Harold, are going to string them along for 9 years, give you less than average sex, ooh, and you know what? Ooh. Never propose.
That didn't go off really well. Look, is there any way I can get you guys to not broadcast this?
Harold, we're on the radio as we speak, brother.
We're on the radio, dude. So listen, but you know that's how it works.
Can we just not air this one?
It's happening.
Harold,
I gotta go talk.
Harold, listen to me. She is very clear on what she wants. You have a chance to fix this if that's what you think you can do.
Harold, be real with us, brother. Is it you that doesn't want the marriage?
You know, it just never came up.
It's time, and it's here now.
In the past 2 years, we've had two proposals on the radio. Do you want us to call her back right now? Do you want to ask those magical words on the radio, Harold?
No. What? On the radio? No. That's not what I want.
If you want her back, now it's go time. I mean, you need to really dig deep and figure out what you want, because she's out.
It's women.
Women?
Whoa. Oh, my God.
Uh-oh. Triggered.
New 102.7.
Oh my God, are you all right? You want to punch him?
You know what? That ended just like it was supposed to.
Yeah.
Ooh. So it's Karen, Johnny, and Anthony, and it's also Wendy's Wednesday. We've got your chance to win a couple of pairs of tickets to see the Yanks. We're going to do that at 8:25, okay? Yes. Mm-hmm. So that is on the way. But right now, what did you accidentally put somewhere? Like, I lost my keys yesterday morning. You guys know I was a little bit late. In the morning, I put my keys in the refrigerator.
Karen.
Were you saving them for later?
I don't know. I think I was putting something away and then putting the keys, and I mixed it up in my head and I did the opposite.
Keys.
Do you know how long
fridge.
It took me to find that? Because you're not looking in the fridge.
Oh my God.
You're not alone.
I feel like such a scatterbrain lately. I'm doing the dumbest things.
The Apple TV remote?
It's so tiny, first of all. It always gets lost.
And I was looking. I pulled apart my couch. Because, of course, that's the first thing you do. You go in the cushions. It was in the fridge. I put the remote in the fridge.
So we're totally thinking of something else when that happens. Like, we're gone.
What are we doing?
Gone.
We have Windex in the fridge. A lot of people have put things in the fridge. I don't think we're alone.
We have a fridge problem here at this morning show. I've poured myself a glass of water, and our fridge has the outside water thing that you hit the trigger.
Bougie.
The water comes out. And then I swear to God, I was like, what the hell did I just do with my cup of water? I know I just poured it for myself.
Uh-huh.
I thought I was in like a Matrix glitch.
Uh-huh.
I opened up the doors to the fridge. There it is, sitting on the top shelf of the fridge.
At least
Why?
It was liquid.
And I also did this. I did something similar. Opened a Diet Coke. I know I opened a fresh Diet Coke.
Yeah.
It was cold. Where is it? I put it in the pantry.
Oh.
So, okay. I guess I was putting food away at the same time, and I had it in my hand. What if you accidentally put somewhere when you weren't thinking?
Do you have a fridge problem?
Oh, people are already calling.
Or any kind of misplacing problem.
And then finding it, like finding the Windex in the fridge was, I had to like book a therapy appointment.
That's what I mean. You're like, am I crazy? What? Wait, what? 800-949-1027.
Hey, New York City.
Sour Music is brought to you by your local Mazda dealer. Download the Odyssey app for exclusive stations. From 90s Crush to Odyssey, all new. And then come back to upbeat variety. New 102.7.
Hi, New 102's problem.
Hi, this is Michelle calling. I got the funniest story for you.
Oh my God, please make us feel better.
It happened to my husband about 2 months ago. He's looking for his cell phone. He cannot find it anywhere. We're calling it. He looked in his car. He ripped his car apart. We're calling it. And he kept calling it. He called. They suspended the line and they said that we should report it stolen.
Wow.
We go to the police department, report it stolen. Or lost, blah, blah, blah. We come home. I go in the fridge, and where's his phone?
No.
In the fridge.
I'm like,
no!
I'm in the fridge!
I swear to God.
There should be.
Are you freaking kidding me? Your phone is right here.
Oh, my God. That feeling is the worst feeling. You're like, who
Wait,
am I?
And mind you, I must have been in that fridge 1,000 times for my coffee, phone, you know, for my milk.
Thank you for making us feel better, and we want everybody to join the conversation of what did you put in the fridge?
I know. We have a fridge problem, a national fridge problem. I'm so glad he found his phone. 800-949-1027. What did you misplace? And then you couldn't believe where you found it.
New 1027, WNEW-FM, WNEW-HD1, New York. Commercial free at 9, noon, 2, and 3.
An Odyssey station.
Seven, what's your name?
Susan.
Susan, what did you accidentally misplace and then couldn't believe where you found it?
Well, it wasn't me. I was coming home from grocery shopping and my sons were really little and I was trying to unload the car and one of them was kind of getting in my way, so I gave him my house keys to play with and poof, they were gone. And I tossed the whole house for like 2 weeks looking through these keys. I mean, I had other keys because wow. These were my main set of keys.
Right.
And I almost had to pull the trigger and get new keys. And my cleaning lady found them. My son, he couldn't even talk. He was that little. But he unzipped one of the cushions of the couch and stuffed them in.
Smart hiding spot.
That is a really good hiding place, though.
Now we know where she keeps her money.
There is no way you would have found that. That is incredible. 800-949-1027. What did you lose and then could not believe where you found it?
New 1027.
Video.
New 1027.
Live from the Aircheck Studio.
Help care that cares.
Turn it up.
New 1027.
Hi, New 1027. What's your name?
Hi, it's Martha.
Martha, what did you lose and then couldn't believe where you found?
I was at a party with my friend. I thought I put food in the microwave and I put my cell phone in it.
Please tell me you didn't turn it on.
Yes, I did.
What?
Wait, no. So did the sparks and fire give you the clue, or?
I was a little happy, to say the least.
Yes.
When I got home.
You're lucky you still have a home and it didn't burn down from the iPhone in the microwave.
Well done.
I like my iPhone medium rare, Kat.
Yeah, seriously. Hi, New 1027. Who's this?
Hi, it's Laura from Little Ferry.
Hey, Laura. So what did you lose and where did you find it?
Three crazy teenagers. I'm sure everybody can relate. Trying to get them ready for school. And I'm like, trying to make cereal and stuff. I'm like, get your cereal, get your milk. They go, we don't have milk. I said, we have a gallon of milk in the refrigerator. I just bought it. I'm looking around, go to pop something in the microwave. Milk's in the microwave.
No.
I have no idea how it got there.
No. Oh, my
no
God.
No idea.
Because you're doing 9,000 things.
And I'm going, right? And I'm going like, where is the salami? I look up to grab a paper plate. It's in the paper plate section. I'm like, what is happening in my house?
Yeah, but thank God you found that salami, because otherwise that would be a really smelly problem.
That would have been really gross. Like, what is that smell, right?
Are we all sober during this? Because I'm sober as hell.
I don't think we're brain sober.
That's a good word for it. Brain sober. It's not often that it happens. So at 8:25, right, Ann? Okay,
yes.
8:25, we've got your chance to win a pair of tickets to see 2 New York Yankees 2022 regular season games. Okay, we're going to ask you a little trivia that happens at 8:25. In the meantime, we got some funny texts on losing something and where you found it.
We do. Also, I just want to tell you, Kara, I've never felt dumber than when I put Windex in the fridge. It was a moment for me that I was like, I'm the stupidest person alive, but this text beats that. You ready?
Yeah.
973, my son was 2 years old and put our chihuahua in the fridge.
Not the chihuahua.
The chihuahua in the fridge.
Not the chihuahua.
A 3-month-old chihuahua. Oh, and wait, that's what happened to the Taco Bell dog.
Please tell me somebody hurt that dog.
There's no outcome. I hope the chihuahua's okay.
I think the chihuahua's okay. We're just going to go with that. What did you lose? And then you could not believe where you found it. 800-949-1027. Hi, New 1027. What's your name?
Hi, my name is Debbie.
Debbie, what did you lose and where did you find it?
I lost my glasses and I went to started preparing dinner, went into the refrigerator. Turns out I had exchanged places my glasses for yogurt.
How did the yogurt feel on your eyes? That must have been like a nice little, you know, facial. Hi, New 1027. What's your name?
Hey, good morning. It's Melissa.
Melissa, help us out, man. We feel so stupid. What did you lose and where did you end up putting it?
So I have this, like, very distinct memory. When I was a kid, like, probably 6 years old, I had lost a tooth. And you know when you lose a tooth and you're that little, you don't really know what to do with it. There's no adults around when it happens.
Okay.
So I must have done something and lost track of what I had done with it. And my mother was like, well, what happened to the tooth? And for a couple of days, we could not figure out what I had done with it.
Wow.
And we found it sitting on a little pine needle on the Christmas tree.
Because why couldn't it be a decoration? A nice little tooth?
I don't know if I put it there or... Completely no idea how it got there.
Do you know how many pine needles are on a Christmas tree? The fact that you found that tooth laying on a pine needle is pretty incredible. Hey, the tooth fairy just had to get there. That's all.
Good sense of humor.
Oh my gosh. I can't believe where we leave things sometimes, right? We just have like a brain fart. It's awful.
My jaw just dropped at this next. We just read a text that a kid accidentally put a chihuahua in the fridge.
He was a baby.
Okay,
so was the chihuahua, but everything turned out okay.
This text tops that, Car. Brace yourselves. Brace yourselves for what I'm about to say.
Uh-oh.
Just say it.
732, I was a kid and I couldn't find my cat anywhere.
Uh-oh.
And our dryer was making loud noises. The cat was in the dryer that was on.
No!
They opened the dryer and the cat rocketed out. The cat was okay.
With a fluffy, nice coat afterwards, I'm sure. Smelling like bounce. I just have to have happy endings on this stuff. We're taking your calls. 800-949-1027 on where did you lose something and where did you find it? But don't forget, next we're going to take your calls for Wendy's Wednesday. So much fun when it's Wendy's Wednesday because we've got not one, but two pairs of tickets to see the Yanks at a regular season game, okay? We'll do that next. We're having so much fun this morning talking about, you know, just having that blank brain and putting something where it doesn't belong. You find your you find your keys in the fridge. Hey, someone put their cat in a dryer. And I don't know how that happened, but the cat's okay.
It was okay. And there were dryer sheets in there too, Car. So he had a nice little
I know. And then perm. The little chihuahua was in the fridge.
Oh.
So funny.
It what happens you got to people. So my dad fought with me over this because when we come into our front door, we all leave our shoes right by the front. On the rug, as soon as you walk in.
Right.
Screaming at me that I touched his shoes and now they're gone. We couldn't find him anywhere. Ripping the whole house apart. He took them off outside of the house first before he walked in for some reason. I don't know what kind of brain fart that was, but left them on the mat outside of the house as opposed to inside the house.
Come on, Dad.
See, once you change your habits, it's all over. But you do mindless things.
Yes!
And Janet Planet, our intern, what did you do? Because I know you make us feel better here.
Yeah, so I was getting ready for an event, and I accidentally just left my curling iron in the fridge.
Oh, left it in the fridge.
Left it in the fridge.
I left it in the fridge for a couple hours. I mean, it was cooling down, so I guess it did the job.
Right. So was that by accident, or is that your method for cooling your curling iron down?
Okay. I don't think that would be a method, but I think it helped. So, yeah, I think it went well.
That was a good outcome.
Yes.
I'm glad you found it.
I did find it.
Speaking of cooling down, 631, I have to do one last thing. Not sure about this one, but I did find my wife's thong in the freezer. A frozen thong.
She's was she trying to use it as an ice pack, an eye patch ice pack?
Is that what you're putting
in? Perhaps. I'm just trying to think of reasoning.
Let us know.
Maybe
about
she
that.
Went by it with the laundry basket and it fell in there, okay?
It fell in the freezer?
I don't know. Maybe it's a bottom drawer one like I have.
My theory?
Oh.
Look at me looking for all these answers.
You're getting to the bottom of this. That's true. It could have fell in the bottom freezer.
Nope, I got a theory. What's this area code?
631. That's Suffolk County, Long Island.
631's having an affair. Her husband was walking in. She took the thong and threw it in the freezer quick to hide it.
I got to tell you something. Thongs end up everywhere. My five-year-old son went to kindergarten, and my thong fell out of his pant leg because it got, static cling in the dryer.
Stop.
Mrs. Boda, I think this belongs to you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, so, yeah, thongs have a way of disappearing. Anyway.
And winding up in your kid's kindergarten class. This is great.
It was in his pant leg. Karen. From the dryer. Okay, that's a true story.
Hi, Ms. Carson. Right. We're going to need you to come in and talk about some things.
It's Wendy's Wednesday. Woo! Call now. We've got two pair of tickets to see a regular season New York Yankee game. They are red hot. And this is from our friends at Wendy's, the official hamburger of the New York Yankees. 800-949-1027.
New 1027.
My husband's...
Let's go!
It's time to kick off the workday
with the first of four commercial-free hours. Half your workday is commercial-free
on New 102.7.
Hi, New 102.7. What's your name?
My name's Matt.
Where are you calling from?
Madison, New Jersey.
Okay, Matt. We're going to ask you some Yankee trivia. I think you're going to get it if you're a Yankee fan, okay?
All right, let's do it.
All right. If you get it right, tickets are yours. Derek Jeter and his wife have three children. Are they all boys or all girls?
Oh,
all girls.
Yes!
Nice!
He knows his Derek Jeter. He knows his Yankees. You just won two pairs of tickets. I love Derek, too. You just won two pairs of tickets to the New York Yankees 2022 regular season game from our friends at Wendy's. Congratulations.
Awesome. Thank you.
Let's go, Yankees.
Let's go, Yankees.
Woo! Have a great time at the games.
Let's go, Yankees.
Look, he's still going. We love you. New 102.7, it is going to be another fabulous day. Sunshine, high 82, and we are commercial free on New 102.7. Uh-oh, Adele's boyfriend, Rich Paul, is hinting he wants more kids. He wants to be an older dad. It's Adele on New 102.7.
New 102.7. Commercial free at 9, noon, 2, and 3.
I need you to stay. I need you to stay.
New 102.7. WNEW-FM. WNEW-HD1. New York.
It's my favorite station.
Upbeat variety and commercial free.
An Odyssey station.
Ed Sheeran seen out in London wedding the baby's head.
Why was he wedding a baby's head?
It means celebrating the birth of your baby. Basically drinking.
Every time you come, I'm kissing you.
People are upset. It looks like Kim Kardashian may have ruined Marilyn Monroe's dress that she wore to the Met Gala.
Kind of stretched it out, right?
She stretched it out a little bit, and there's some rhinestones missing. That dress is an antique.
Add it to the list of things Kim Kardashian has ruined.
New 102.7.
New 102.7 commercial free from the Arch Care Studio.
Healthcare that cares.
New 102.7. And commercial free.
Yeah.
New 102.7.
Some of my clothes would fit.
Tonight.
New 102.7. Karen, Johnny, Anthony, thanking you so much for listening.
Yes.
The gorgeous Emily West is in next on New 102.7.